Hi guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, it is always one of my favorite videos of the year to film. I'm going to be sharing with you my Sephora VIB sale recommendations. So just the products that I recommend you purchase while you can get some money off. So if you want to see the items that I have picked out, then just keep watching. Also, today's video is in collaboration with one of my best friends here on YouTube, Isabella Goria. Bella, I freaking love that girl. Her and I have collaborated a few times before, so this is nothing new for my channel. And actually, last year for this time of year's VIB sale, we collaborated on this video already. And I don't know, I love collabing with her. And since we did this last year, why not do it again? Her and I have a very similar taste in makeup. She also does a lot of different style, like lifestyle videos on her channel as well. She has an awesome fashion sense. She does a lot of hauls, a lot of clothing hauls, a lot of makeup videos, and just general lifestyle videos as well. I love her. She's like one of the most sweet people on the internet, I swear. So cute, so bubbly, and just a genuinely deep down good person. I know you guys are going to love her channel if you aren't subscribed to her already, but I'm so excited to collaborate with her on this video again. I don't know, Bella, I think we need to collab on this VIB sale video every time it comes up because I love collabing with you. So the dates of the sale, I almost forgot to tell you. Let me pull up my photos. The sale is starting April 17th if you are a Rouge member, where you will be receiving 20% off. It's going to range from April 17th to May 1st for you. Make sure you all use code SPRINGSAVE. If you are just a regular VIB, it's going to be 15% off for you starting April 21st to the 29th. And if you are just an insider, you get 10% off starting April 23rd going to the 27th. So that's all the information you need to know. Let me also give a little bit of a disclaimer before I upset people. If you are not shopping, if you are not in the financial situation where you can be shopping right now, please don't. You know, makeup is not a priority during these times. You know, scary things are going on in the world. People are put into unexpected financial situations. And yeah, if you can't shop, don't. There's going to be plenty of sales in the future. Even now for this sale, I'm not gonna go crazy either. There's no need. I'm not leaving my house. So don't think I'm being insensitive or disregarding what's going on in the world with this video. Truly, I just do it every sale. My subscribers love it. It's one of my favorite videos to film, and you're watching a makeup channel. I don't know what you expect. Anyways, one of the fun parts about collabing with Bella on this is we always pick a couple of products that we both equally agree should be recommendations. So the first recommendation that we agreed on was the Dior lip oils. These are incredible. So I have mine in the shade Rosewood. I just really like this color because I feel like it enhances my natural lip color. These glow oils are amazing. They're thick enough to stick on your lips because sometimes lip oils can be a little bit too slippery and like slide around on your face. No, this is sticky enough that it stays on your lip and actually works almost as a gloss. The sheer color of it still leaves just a hint on your lips, so that for me with this specific color, it kind of just brings out the natural color of my lips, makes me look more alive, and as it sits on your lips, it moisturizes your lips. This is amazing. I like to put it on if I am not doing too much with my makeup and I just want a little bit of a shine, a little bit of emphasis of my natural lip color. I love this. I highly recommend it, and I know Bella does too. We both love it, and I wasn't sure about this product. I heard a lot of great things about it at first and I was like, it's just a lip oil, and then I tried it and I was hooked. This is amazing. I see what all the hype is about. Such a beautiful product. We also agreed on the Benefit Cheek Stars Reunion Tour Palette. I recommend these every year because I really feel like they are such a great deal. Don't waste your money on the individual products. You get this at such a good value, and for an additional like 20% off, why not? So in here you're getting a Hoola bronzer, which is the bronzer that I use today. This is just a classic everyday color. You have a Georgia blush, which is their new blush. It's a bit light, a little bit sheer, not my favorite in this palette, but it still is really nice. A Dallas blush, which is a great everyday color. Sugar Bomb, which is a nice light pink color. And then Cookie Highlighter, which is one of my favorite highlighters of all time. Love this highlighter so much. I really love the warmer tones that they put in this year, and I just buy these every year because they are a great quality product, a really fantastic value, and while you can get it for an additional percentage off, why not? And you know, I have a very light skin tone. Bella has more of a medium skin tone, and this also looks really beautiful on her as well. So two different skin tones, and we still absolutely love it. So highly recommend this palette so much. So now it's time to get into the favorites that Bella doesn't know that I picked out. I was trying to keep it small and reasonable just for the time of the year, but because I don't know how to hold myself back, looking at the table right now, I failed miserably. But anyways, these are all great products that I highly recommend. And first I want to start off with an older product. I could do a whole video on Sephora VIB products that I always recommend every single time. I say this in every sale video for the VIB sale, but this is a great time to stock up on your mascaras, your eyeliners, things that you use all the time, your eyebrow pencils, things that you know you're going to repurchase once you run out, so you might as well get it while you can get a percentage off. It's a great time to restock or try out new skincare as well. Skincare is expensive, but it is important. And also those luxury items that you've been eyeing for a while, this is the time to get them. With that aside, let's get into the products that I am recommending. So this one is kind of my item that I need to repurchase. I wasn't going to share this at first, but I figured since I am purchasing this and it's a repurchase, I might as well share it with you guys. But this is the Smashbox Photo Finish Primerizer. This is the most moisturizing primer that I've ever tried. It is one of my all-time favorites, and I'm like right at the very bottom. I don't plan on switching this out for a different type of primer. I need this primer in my collection at all times. I have a lot of really nice moisturizing primers, but I just need this one because it feels so refreshing on the skin. It's so light because it is more of a liquidy consistency, and it just feels so refreshing, so smoothing, and it really quenches the thirst that my dry skin has. So I love this. This is what I personally am picking up, so I figured I would recommend it to you as well. I have a new moisturizing lip balm that I'm obsessed with that is way too overpriced for a lip balm, but it's great. This is the Tatcha the Kisu Lip Mask. I talked about this in my March favorites, and you all were very, very intrigued. I am liking this right now more than my Laneige lip mask. It's a bit lighter of a consistency. I feel the Laneige is a bit sticky. This one is a gel. It soaks into the skin better, I feel. It's not as thick, but it's just as moisturizing. So I like the consistency of this on my lips better than the Laneige, and I'd argue it might moisturize my lips a little bit better than the Laneige. So I have been loving this, putting this on every morning, every time I go to bed. It's been an awesome purchase, so I wanted to recommend that for you guys. Like, who doesn't need a lip balm? So it's an essential. It's good. Next up, I did want to mention one foundation or base kind of product for you guys. I'm not wearing it in today's video because your girl wanted a little bit full coverage, but with the weather getting warmer, it is time to switch over to your tinted moisturizers, lighter skin products. So I did want to recommend the Laura Mercier Tinted Moisturizer. This has been a classic for years. They reformulated last year, and I just love the reformulation. I think it is beautiful. I will link down below my original review last year when I tried out this tinted moisturizer. There's something about this that just makes your skin look so much better. You're literally getting like no coverage with this, but just the way it sits on the skin just makes your skin look so much more even, and it's very, very natural. Even if like you're getting ready for a conference call or a Zoom call, since we can't leave our house, this is just something easy to throw on to refresh your skin, to make everything just look prettier and better, and to make you feel a little bit more confident. So this is even great for wearing around the house to keep your skin moisturized and just to give you that little pick-me-up that you need. I think one of the best tricks to being productive while at home is to get ready at the beginning of the day, even if it is just throwing on a little bit of tinted moisturizer and mascara. Doing that a lot of times helps you prepare for the day and helps you just feel more motivated and ready, like it's time to work. And this is a great product to throw on. It's very light and it makes your skin look awesome. Concealer. Okay, this is going to be absolutely no surprise to you because I have not been holding back about how I feel about the Pat McGrath Skin Fetish Sublime Skin Perfecting Concealer. Ooh, this is my current favorite concealer. That I have mine in the shade Light Medium 9. This is full coverage without being too cakey. It is not a thin consistency, but given how much coverage it gives you, it is kind of thin. I really like that despite the coverage. It also isn't drying somehow. You know, Tarte Shape Tape, yeah, you get so much coverage, but that made my under eyes look like the Sahara Desert. This has a little bit less coverage, but it is made up for in the consistency of the concealer. It's just one of the best that I've ever tried. You need this. It's really, really good. I don't know what else to say about it. I've already waxed poetic about it enough, but I love it. And then, of course, you have to get the under eye setting powder too. I am so sorry. I have mine in the shade Light. I think I might actually pick up a medium as well while the sale is happening, because this powder is so finely milled. It is so blurring on the skin that I need this in a darker shade so I can put it all over my face. I mean, despite that, I already put this all over my face, and my skin just looks so beautifully blurred and set. and I need it in a darker color because I want to do so much more with this powder. Put it everywhere. I haven't come across a powder that is so silky. It is crazy. So this is my new favorite under eye setting powder as well. I don't know what it was or what magic she put into this, but oof, these are so good. I think she needs to come out with a foundation that kind of corresponds a little bit more with this concealer, because if it's anything like this concealer, we are in for a treat, people. But these are like my two favorite products of the moment ever. So now let's get into some powder products. First, I want to talk about my favorite blush palette currently, and that is the NARS Overlust Cheek Palette. I resisted on this for so many weeks, and eventually I had to cave in. I am so glad that I did. I just love the colors in here, except I can't get it open. If you are a neutral blush lover, you are going to love the colors in here. Now, I do have to admit, not the biggest fan of the highlighters. They're a nice, like, really creamy texture, and they do look really pretty and smooth on the skin, but I don't know, they lack something for me. They're not my favorite formula. I think they're okay, but the blushes stand out so much to me, and the highlighters pair nice with the blush, but I always go to other products for highlights, but I do like them as blush toppers, and if you're just, like, really neutral, kind of more leaning warm blushes, you're going to love this. This has the perfect, most approachable colors. The formula is really nice, and I mean, who doesn't love a good NARS blush palette? And this is an incredible time to purchase this because it is an incredible product. Okay, so this I'm really only recommending for medium and deep skin tones because I just love the texture of this blush. This is the Natasha Denona Bloom Highlighting Blush. This is one of her new blushes. It's $20, and for Natasha Denona, that is not a bad price at all. You're getting how many grams of product? 4 grams of product for $20, and then that's before the extra percentage off. Okay, on me, I'm wearing it today. I've used it a few times now, and it's a bit too bright for me, but I try and make it work because I love the texture of it on the skin. It just has just the right amount of sheen and glow to it without being glittery. It blends out really beautifully, and I just love the tone of this blush. I don't really think it's made for us light skin tone people, so don't really recommend it. If you do have a lighter skin tone and you want to use this blush, lightly pat like once, shake it off, pat it on your hand, and then put it on your cheeks to get that really pretty wash of color. But medium and deep skin tones, you are going to love this. It is very reminiscent of Orgasm X. That is what somebody commented, and I do have to agree with you. I don't own Orgasm X from NARS, but it does remind me of that, and I have got a lot of questions as to how this compares to the bigger palettes. After this video, I'm going to take pictures comparing this to the colors in the Daria and Citrus palette. I'm gonna post that on my community tab, so make sure you put on your notification bell, and I will post that on my community tab, and you'll be notified when I post it. Also, to remind you, I did use my Sonia G soft cheek brush to apply it, which was the perfect brush because it's not too dense. And if you didn't hear, Sonia G, she has restocked today, so hopefully her brushes are still available. Again, if you missed it, it's because your notification bell is not on for me because I posted about it. Okay, just saying. Had to remind you. Also, something very, very exciting. The Hourglass Ambient Metallic Strobe Lighting Palette did come to Sephora. I was worried that it wasn't going to, but it did. So if you aren't aware, this came out in 2017 for the holiday collection. Everybody went crazy over this highlighting trio, and it was limited edition, and it didn't come back until 3 years later. So this is a new re-release. People have been dying for this trio, and this is the Metallic Ambient Powder, and the Metallic Ambient Powder isn't very common in Hourglass. You can't just go and pick up one of their metallic powders. So this is the time to get it. You can't buy these shades individually. You can't buy this formula individually. So today I used my Sonia G Cheek Pro Brush and I mixed it in these two. And you'll see my demo, I applied way too much, but just so you can see how much power these beaming highlights have. And I think what's really special about them is how easy they are to blend into the skin, not onto the skin. So even though it was kind of scary upon initial application, I took it over to the other cheek, blended the product in, and now my skin just looks crazy beaming, but my texture isn't emphasized. So if you don't like a beaming highlight, I think Hourglass has better options for you in other powders. What I like about these powders and what I think is special is that you can really work them into the skin to kind of tone them down and get the look that you're looking for, or you can kind of be obnoxious. But this is one of those special highlighters where it doesn't emphasize texture and it looks very glowy. You know, I could not do without eyeshadow. videos. And of course, I think now is the time to invest into your luxury eyeshadow brands that you've been eyeing if you have. And I recently did a Tom Ford ranking video and you guys loved it and you're telling me what's on your wish list. Now is the time to pick up those Tom Ford quads you have been eyeing. Last I could see, Daydream, which was my number one favorite Tom Ford quad, was sold out at Sephora. So I don't know if they're going to restock that, but that is available at Nordstrom. But the ones that they do have at Sephora, let me share that I recommend. We have Honeymoon here if you like more of those warmer toned neutrals. I also recommend the Classic Nude Dip. This is kind of a, if you are going to collect Tom Ford, you need to have Nude Dip kind of color. It's a cult favorite. It's more of those cool tone neutrals, but even if you don't like cool tones, like, this is still really pretty. I highly recommend. And then I think I put so many of you guys onto this quad because it's incredible. Pretty Baby Purple Eyeshadow Lovers. This one is so good. This duochrome is one of the most incredible duochrome shades ever. So if you're looking into maybe picking up your first Tom Ford or adding to your collection, now is the time to do it because these babies are expensive. Also, for Natasha Denona, I have two recommendations. Of course, we have the new Mini Retro Palette, which is pretty affordable to begin with. This is $25, but hey, if you can get it for an additional percentage off, why not? You know, I really enjoyed this little palette a lot. I think it's a great way to try Natasha Denona, especially if you can get it cheaper. It's super cute and the colors are great for spring. The only thing is, I feel like this looks better on people with more of a yellow undertone because these shades, if you're not very yellow, they can pull more gray. And I was hoping for more of like an olive green kind of color with these, but on my pale skin tone, it just looks super gray on me, which I don't mind. I like gray shadow, but just wasn't what I was expecting. But other than that, the quality of this is fantastic and I really love the colors in here for spring. So this is a great option. And then of course I had to mention my love palette from Natasha Denona. This is one of her newest palettes. And if you like pinky purple kind of shadows, you will really enjoy this palette. I don't like her cream to powder formula in here. She has a couple of those. Other than those like two duds, everything else is fine. Beautiful formula. Really great value to begin with as well. Perfect size. And you get to own that Natasha Denona formula. So I'm wearing the love palette right now. If you would like to see how I did this look, I basically did an almost identical look on my original review of this palette, so I would check that out to see what I used. I also have an individual tutorial using this where I created more of a red look, so you really have to like those purple red kind of tones, otherwise you won't like this palette. So I definitely don't think this is for everybody, but I just wanted to remind you that this is out there ready to be purchased. And then a last brand of eyeshadows that I wanted to share with you is Charlotte Tilbury. So I want to recommend the Pillow Talk Instant Eye Palette to you guys. I personally love her big shadow palettes. I think the formula in them tends to be really special and you really see how good her formula is when you have a wider range of tones. Now with this palette, it is all kind of the same tone. I do think some of her bigger palettes are better and have more variety. If you love these tones, you will love this palette. The quality in here is incredible. You can get more wearable looks. You can get more crazy cranberry looks, but I love this guy. I think it's really pretty and I love a good pink eyeshadow. So I like this and I recommend it. But also what came to Sephora is her Eye Magic Color Collection. Again, I did a full review on that collection. Loved it. So basically she came out with four different quads that are supposed to emphasize the color of your eye. But the two that I love, and I talked about these in my favorites, so I don't want to go too far into it, but I love Mesmerizing Maroon. This one has more maroon, almost plumish shades. So if you like these tones, you will really like this one. And then also the Rebel, or this one is actually called Green Lights, but this used to be called the Rebel. If you like more green tones, you will really love this one. Any Charlotte Tilbury quad that you've been eyeing, I would recommend picking them up. I always try and pick up at least one Charlotte Tilbury quad during the sales because I am working on broadening my collection of these guys because the formula of these are so good. What I really like about the quads especially is that you can just kind of splash these on your eyes and your eyes look amazing. The way that her eyeshadows shimmer are very unique to where you can put shimmer all over your eyelid and it actually doesn't look ridiculous. So there is something about the way that these sparkle on the eye, and if you follow her recommendations for the prime, the contour, the smoke, and the pop, it's just a really thoughtless look. And I mean, they are a little bit expensive, but I would be lying if I said I didn't didn't love her quads, so now is the time to pick them up. But of her new ones, I love Mesmerizing Maroon and I love Green Lights. A last item that I have to recommend to you guys is the skincare item that I have been obsessed with, has changed my skincare routine. This is the Erno Laszlo Detoxifying Cleansing Oil. I will never go without a double cleanse in my routine again. So what a double cleanse is you use an oil-based cleanser first and then you go in with your regular cleanser. The point is the oil-based cleanser is supposed to get off the residual makeup that you left on your face. There are some that recommend you take your makeup off with. I like to take my makeup off first and let this get whatever my dirty self left over, and I think it really has improved the cleanliness of my skin, which has reduced the amount of breakouts that I've had. Because it's an oil, it also feels very moisturizing on my dry skin, and truly I think it's just completely changed my skin. So I've been loving the detoxifying cleansing oil from Erno Laszlo. It has been a game changer in my skincare routine, so I wanted to recommend that to you guys. That was a mouthful. That is all I have for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Of course, don't feel obligated to shop for the sale. There will be plenty of sales in the future. I mean, I am gonna purchase from the sale though. Somebody's got to stimulate the economy, okay? And I will take one for the team. But no, don't put yourself at financial risk for makeup. It's not that serious. But I did want to share with you some of the things that I thought would be nice to purchase. So that is all I have for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and found it helpful. Make sure you check out Bella's video to see the products that she recommends for the sale. These are one of my favorite videos to watch as well. I just love seeing what people love from Sephora. I mean, who doesn't, you know? I want to know what some of your picks are that you are picking up from the sale if you can, what you're putting on your wish list for the future. If you aren't subscribed to my channel, I hope you guys take the time to do so and make sure you go subscribe to Bella as well. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys, have a good one.